What is going on, guys? It's Bucky and welcome to your ninth C++ tutorial, and in this tutorial I'm going to be talking more about functions. Now I talked about this a little bit in, like, I don't know, a couple tutorials ago, but I want to talk about it again because I really want to stress what functions are and why they are useful in C++ programming. So if you remember, a function is basically a computer program is made up of a bunch of functions. Right now we have one function right here, and basically the job of a function is to do something. So inside function we can give our program a bunch of separate instructions, all followed by a semicolon. So our main function that we already learned is the starting point for every computer program. Every program starts with the function main. So this is one function right here, but let's go ahead and create another function. And in order to do that, go ahead and separate from your main. So before we were coding everything inside the main function, but now we want to create another function. So go outside main right here. Now the first thing that we need is a return type. And this is whenever people build functions, they usually make a calculation and give you back something. For example, if we had a function to calculate the speed of my car, it would give me back a number. If we had a function to calculate my weight, it would give me back a number. Well, sometimes functions make calculations, and sometimes when they don't make calculations, just as like printing something out on the screen, it doesn't really need to calculate anything. So sometimes functions are gonna return a number to you. In that case you would use int, and sometimes they just do stuff like print something out on the screen and don't return any answer to you. Whenever a function doesn't return anything to you, just go ahead and put void. And this means, you know, function, just go ahead and do your thing and I don't want anything in return. So the very first thing you write is the return type of the function. So this one, you see it returned a number, but this one is just gonna print something out on the screen, so it's gonna return void. So after this, you go ahead and you name your function. This one is named main, and you can actually name it anything you want. This function is just gonna print something out on screen, like I said, so I'm just gonna name it print something. Pretty dumb, I know, but hey, it's my function, I can do what I want. So after this, you see that I added two little curly braces, and those are actually called parameters. Whenever your function needs additional information, you add parameters, but we're going to be covering this in the next tutorial. For now, just remember to add them and add nothing in between them. Trust me, I'm going to be covering this in the next tutorial, and I'm going to make it real easy to understand. But after these parentheses, go ahead and add two curly brackets. And just like I said before, this is the body of your function. For example, if you had a function called make peanut butter and jelly, inside your body you would have a set of instructions like get out the bread, next instruction, put peanut butter on one slice, next instruction, put jelly on one slice, lastly, eat it. Well, in the body of our function, we give it each instruction about what we want this function to do. So in our function called print something, the only thing that we want this function to do is print something out on the screen. Easy enough, we already know how to do that. So let's go ahead and cout. Oops, there we go. And what are we gonna print out on the screen? Just write like, ooh, I am text on the screen. It's a very feminine function we have here. But anyways, then just go ahead and end the line. Simple enough. So now whenever we use this function, whenever you use a function, it's called calling the function. Why they did that, I don't know, but just remember, whenever I say call the function, I basically just mean use the function. So whenever we call this function, all it's going to do is print out, ooh, I am text on the screen. Simple enough. So let's go ahead and remember, since our computer program starts with main, we need to tell it in main that this is the function that we want to use. So in order to use or call a function, all you do is this. Just go ahead and write print something, empty parameters, and a semicolon. So again, anytime you want to use a function, just go ahead and type the name of the function, empty parameters, and a semicolon. But check this out. Whenever we try and build and run this, we're gonna get an error. This with this little rectangle means. You can't read my error message because it's down here, but it says printing something was not declared in the scope. And you're saying, alright, What did we do wrong? Because Bucky told me that this function is built perfectly, which it is, but whenever it tried to call it or use it right here, it didn't understand what was going on. So why is our compiler kind of confused? Well, the reason is this. Computer programs work from the top down. It starts at the very top line and it runs downward until it gets to the very end and then it quits. So whenever our computer program was running, it said this, all right, include this file, done. Use this, done. Okay, now start with main, print something. What the heck? I never seen that before. Is this a function, or are we trying to make a variable, or what the heck are we doing? I don't know what this means. Well, that's because whenever we created our function, we created it after we used it. We need to tell C++ before we use our function that it is actually a function. So we have a couple ways of doing this. Probably the easiest way is just to do this. Go ahead and cut it, and then above your main, go ahead and paste it. And now C++ is going to think like this. All right, I'm going to include this, simple enough. I'm going to use this, easy enough. And oh, you made a function called print something now. Okay, I'll remember that. So now whenever I call my main and I come across this thing called print something, I know that it's a function that you created. So that's why whenever I build and run it now, it's going to run perfectly without any errors. So that is basically how a computer program works. First, you need to tell it that you are actually creating a function before you can use that function. So if you just try and use it, it's not going to know what it is if you didn't create it first. So we're saying, all right, I'll just remember to create all my functions before I use them. Okay, you can do that, but let me give you an alternative method of doing this. If for some reason you like your main at the top and you like to create your functions after, well, we already know that whenever you try to run this, we're going to get an error. But there is one thing that you can do, and this is called function prototyping. And all this is this. Trust me, it's the easiest thing ever. Go ahead and select your return type, your function name, and the parentheses, and go ahead and copy that. Now, above your main and under your using, go ahead and paste this. This is called the function prototype, and it's pretty much a copy of your function's header. And it basically is saying this. All right, whenever you run this program now, go ahead and include this, and then we're gonna, this is called prototyping a function. This is pretty much telling our C++ program this. All right, later on, you're gonna come across something called print something. Now, whenever you come across it, we don't want you to freak out like you have before, sending us a whole bunch of error messages. What we're telling you right now is we created a function called print something, but you have to go find it. And C++ is going to say, oh, all right. Now, whenever I try to run my main and I come across this function, instead of giving you an error message, I'm going to know that this is a function that you have somewhere in your program. So I'm not going to freak out. I know this is a function. I know to handle it accordingly. So check it out. Whenever you try and build and run this, it works perfectly. So that is why you need to do one of two things before you use your function in main. One, you can prototype it, or two, you can just go ahead and make your function before main. Either way, whenever you run this function in main, it needs to know beforehand some way that this is a function. So those are your two different ways of doing that. And again, in order to create a function, go ahead and type the return type, the function name, and the parameters. And again, I'm going to be talking about these parameters in the next tutorial. So as long as you understand this and the basis of how to create a function and how to use them in main, you're ready to move on to the next tutorial. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial.